So in this video, I am going to respond to a question from Abraham Osman, who's in my Facebook group. He's also a customer of mine, and I'm gonna respond to his question around cold emailing. So he is sending out some cold emails right now to some lawyers to try and get clients for his SEO service, and he wants me to critique his cold email campaign. So he said, "Hi everyone, I've been emailing people and I've yet to get a reply. Can anyone give me feedback on the email?" And he has his email pasted here. He also said, "I had a signature previously with a picture of mine and my company logo, but I plan on deleting the picture soon. I did follow up on all of them. I'll try to email once more once I have my website set up." Okay, so first thing is, if you have like company logos or images or any of that stuff, I would recommend to remove it because it'll reduce your deliverability and less people are gonna open your emails. So it'll get flagged by like spam filters and if you have a ton of links in there and like website photos and images. So I'd recommend to remove those if you can, keep everything text only. So what I did was I just copied his email here and I posted it or I pasted it into this Google Doc here. And I'm gonna critique his email, give him some feedback and give him a different variation he can use, as well as some tips, tricks and insights for future campaigns that he's running. So this is his actual email. First name, or the subject line is first name, found you on LinkedIn. That's totally fine. This is one of the subject lines that we use and it works. So he goes on to say, "Hi, first name. I came across your profile on LinkedIn and given your background, I thought it would make sense to reach out. I help law firms generate 5 to 10 more clients every month and have clients search for them instead by providing both on-page and off-page search engine optimization SEO services." So the first thing, my critique and feedback is in red here. First thing is I never pitch that I can get them clients. For me, it's just, you don't control that entire process, right? You are, if you're doing SEO or any types of like marketing or advertising services, you are getting them leads, you're getting them inquiries, you're getting them appointments, right? You're not, you can't guarantee them clients because they still have to get on the phone and talk to these leads and turn them into clients. Or if people walk in, if they have like a brick and mortar store, people still have to walk into the store and they still have to turn them into paying clients, right? So I never say I'm gonna get you this amount of clients every month. Another reason is it sets the wrong expectation. So if you tell them I can get you 5 to 10 more clients every month, if you promise this, you're gonna be in trouble if you can't deliver, right? So let's just say you get one client in 3 months. They're gonna be like, "What the hell? I thought you said you'd get me 5 to 10 clients a month and you only got me one client in 3 months." Which is many times if you're doing SEO, it takes a while to get going, right? So the first thing is this offer is not believable to me. I wouldn't, if I was a lawyer, I'd look at this and be like, how would you get me 5 to 10 more clients every month if I can't get one on my own? So the other thing is use language that these guys can understand, right? Most of these people have no clue what on-page or off-page SEO is, and they don't care about that stuff. All they want is more leads and clients. So you wanna speak in those terms, but again, I would not recommend saying I will get you more clients every month because you don't control the entire sales process, okay? So that's my first piece of feedback. Tell them you can get them more inquiries. I'm gonna show you an example of my variation in a second here. You then go on to say we've helped similar companies like the Strategic Legal Group to optimize their website to be constantly ranked first on Google when people search for law firms in their state and acquire 5 to 10 more clients per month. So again, see my feedback over here, Abraham. And make the changes to that. I'm gonna show you my variation, by the way. Is generating more clients something you need help with? If you're not interested, no worries. Thank you for giving us a minute of your time. You can always reply to this email if you have anything to ask. I would remove on the first email, I'd probably remove everything after the question. So I'd remove this here. That's what I would do personally, because you wanna add with that call to action. Okay, so is generating more personal injury cases something you need help with? Okay, so let me show you the variation that I have here. Now, whenever I do something, whether mainly around like copywriting and like sales pages and cold emails or any type of messaging, I like to use frameworks, okay? Notice I'm not saying templates here, I use frameworks. And frameworks are just like the way that things are laid out. So one of the frameworks you can use is BABA, before, after, bridge, in action, okay? Now, Abraham, I know you have my ultimate client acquisition playbook, and this is not mentioned in here. I'm always testing new frameworks to use and split test with the ones that I'm currently running, okay? So this is another one that we're using right now and split testing with. Use this and you'll get some ideas, okay? But why use frameworks instead of templates? Well, If you only think in terms of templates, you don't know what's going on. You don't know why I'm creating the message the way that I'm creating it. You don't know the elements of the message and what makes it work. And if you're just copying and pasting a template, and this goes for all of you guys that are watching this, if you copy and paste a template, you're not gonna see the results you want, right? You need to add your own flavor in there. You need to add your own messaging and your own offer and your own business in there, business info in there. And frameworks are a great way to keep you from just copying and pasting the same message that everyone else is sending, okay? So that's the first thing. Think in terms of frameworks and not just templates, and test other frameworks that are out there. You can do a Google search or find other experts in cold email and see what they're using and testing and go after that. I know Alex Berman, he has his own YouTube channel as well. I've gotten some great ideas from him. I would recommend you go check out his channel as well on his cold emails. So, the framework here, BABA, subject line, personal injury cases. This ties to the result that these personal injury attorneys want. They want more personal injury cases. Okay, so that's why we have that as a subject line. This is gonna get their attention. Hi, first name. If you're like most personal injury attorneys spending money on AdWords, that drills into a pain point they have, right? Some of them pay $80 to $100 a click. You know how expensive it can be to get a single click. And this is their before situation. They're before working with you, what are they experiencing? What are their pain points and their problems that they're currently dealing with right now and before they work with you? Our SEO service changes that, where we help you get X amount of inquiries, you know, 10 to 20 organic personal injury case inquiries per month. We've helped similar companies like the Strategic Legal Group or whoever he listed above to get more of these organic personal injury case inquiries per month without spending money on AdWords. This is their after situation, right? After working with you, what does that look like to them? What is their situation once they start working with you in your service? If you'd be willing to give me 10 minutes of your time, I'd love to show you how we can help you get more personal injury client inquiries per month without AdWords. Okay, and this is the bridge to the call. So now we're bridging to the actual call to action, which is to try and get them to schedule a call with you. Okay, that's the call to action. So which is the last A in this framework here. When's a good time to chat next week about how we can help you get this result? Okay, so very simple. I like to keep these cold emails short and punchy, no more than 3 or 4 lines. Even this is on the longer side for me, if I'm targeting local and small businesses. I like to keep it short and punchy and speaking in their language, okay? So Abraham, if you're watching this, which I mean, you should be watching this after I post this tomorrow, take this, get some ideas from it, and you know, if this doesn't work either, then experiment with other frameworks out there. And within the playbook, I'll probably post a little more frameworks that you can experiment with. But this is a framework here that you can use that we've used successfully recently, BABA, before, after, bridge, and action. And I broke it down here for you, okay? So that was my variation of the first message. Now here's some other feedback and tips. First of all, it is a numbers game with cold email. I don't care what anyone says. In the beginning, when you're testing a new offer, you don't have a ton of clients and social proof, it's a numbers game. So if you don't have that name value, like people don't know who you are, especially in the beginning, you need to test that message and see what's gonna work and see what industry is gonna respond the best. And once you do, then you can scale that up. You can scale the message that works, the niche that works. You're gonna get more case studies and social proof coming in. It's gonna be easier to get clients from there. But in the beginning, it's absolutely a numbers game. So you need to send more than 300 emails. I know you said you sent like 300 or 400 so far. You need to send more than that. So you can't expect to get a client with just 300 emails sent, your first 300 emails sent ever. Number two is follow up like a madman. In addition to email follow-ups, you should reach out via Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, phone. You can do Loom drops as well, like recording a video using the free app Loom. It's a Chrome extension. I'm looking at it in my browser right now. But follow up like a madman, right? Anyone who opens your email, follow up with them. Send them a message on Facebook, on Instagram, on LinkedIn. Give them a phone call if you have their phone number, okay? Follow up with them. Number three is, are people opening your emails? So if they aren't getting open, no one's gonna respond. This is gonna vary depending on what industry you're in, but we shoot for a 40% open rate or more. And that's on the lower end, it's 40%. The fourth thing is to experiment and split test with other cold email frameworks. Alex Berman, again, is another good cold email expert. I'd recommend checking out his YouTube channel. He has some great stuff. Templates can help, but it's never as simple as copy and paste, which is why I always use frameworks so that I can start to think and split test on my own using my own ideas, okay? And then lastly, your offer needs to be believable. So just saying you can get them 5 to 10 clients a month, which is actually huge because these clients for personal injury attorneys can be worth a ton of money, without any landing page or case studies or social proof, it's gonna do more harm than good, okay? Because they're not gonna believe you. They're gonna say, that's BS. You can't get me 5 to 10 clients. Where's the proof? You don't even have a website, okay? So you need to have an offer that's believable. You need to be speaking in their language. And just remember, watch this video again if you need to. Look at my tips from the feedback from your first email here and my adjustments here. And you can make adjustments to your email campaigns going forward using these tips, okay? So if you guys like this video, please give it a like, comment below if you have any questions, and make sure you join my Facebook group as well if you like more stuff like this. I'm not gonna comment or I'm not gonna critique and give every single person a cold email critique like I did for this. I just thought it would be good for a lot of you guys to see so that you can make adjustments to your own cold email campaigns if you're currently running them, okay? So that's it for this video. Again, if you guys want more trainings like this, make sure you join my Facebook group. The link is gonna be below. Make sure you like and comment with any questions or concerns you have, and I'll see you in the next video.